Now, this is an extraordinary story. A woman nursery manager has been spared jail despite being exposed as a paedophile. Alison Whatley, or Whateley, however one pronounces the name, is 44, responsible for hundreds of children, but boasted about her attraction to babies, even telling an undercover investigator that they were, quotes, effing sexy. The case has understandably horrified the parents of children in her care, although police believe none were targeted. The manager, with 25 years' experience in the field, held a video conference with 40 other paedophiles to watch youngsters being abused. She served as senior manager at Bushytails Nursery in Teddington, the same company at Hampton Wick Nursery, and two other nurseries also in southwest London. They've all subsequently been closed. After her arrest, more than 100 parents attended a series of meetings organised by the National Crime Agency. This case was heard at Guildford Crown Court, where Whateley was handed a 5-year sexual harm prevention order restricting her use of computer equipment, but was spared jail and ordered to complete a 30-month community order and 50 days of rehabilitation after hearing, quote, her sad family history, abandoned as a child. Joseph Cotterill Monson is a criminal defence lawyer at the firm Mary Monson Solicitors on Fleet Street, who specialises in this area. I sense, Joseph, there's a lot we don't know about this case, because at first sight it raises a journalistic eyebrow, and I sense it might raise a legal one too. Good morning to you.
Good morning, Nick. Well, I think, first of all, we should probably make the distinction between this issue of anonymity and the offence itself, which led to a sentence which it appears to be lenient. I have to say, when I was speaking with your venerable producer this morning about this story and the summary was being explained to me, my first instinct was this is a person who's a victim of abuse, because there's so much of this case that doesn't really ring as the usual run of things, not least it involves a woman. And the MO, or the profile for an offender, sadly in this type of case, is a man in his 40s or 50s, certainly not a young woman who's working.
What, in cases such as these, what term is allowed? What sort of sentence might someone who offends to this degree be looking at?
Well, if they're Category A images, then sentences in the years are possible, although for a first offence it's becoming increasingly rare. And the reason for that is, I have to say, Nick, in the context of internet and pornography addiction, this has become, and I hesitate to use the word commonplace, but it is so prolific that you would have to double the prison population size if you were to acknowledge each one of these offences, even Category A serious image offences with a prison sentence.
Lastly, Joseph, they talk here about 50 days of, quote, rehabilitation. People will be interested. What does that rehabilitate, to your understanding, what does that comprise?
Well, it's tailor-made, of course, to the offender, but the one of the key things that probation officers are interested in somebody understanding is that there is no such thing as a victimless crime where child pornography viewing is concerned, because it's the viewing itself that creates the market and therefore causes the abuse. If that message gets across, as well as, if it's appropriate, the psychological and kind of counselling that assists somebody in understanding how they fell so far and how they became so degraded, now, they're the types of things that would be looked at.
Grateful for your time, Joseph Cotterill Monson, thank you. You're a criminal defence lawyer, found at the firm Mary Monson Solicitors on Fleet Street in London. You specialise in that area.